ću naformalno da poželim dobrodošlicu našim gostima u Kulturni centar, Austrijskom kulturnom forumu i da im se zahvalim što su ovu kutiću u Požarevačku miru doneli ovdje u nas na tribinu mladih i sad bih prepustila profesoru kojima želite da vam da kažete par reči.
Izvinite, ne govorim dobro srpski, ali mogu da čitam.
Može.
Poštovane dame i gospodo, pre oko 300 godina potpisani su mirovni i trgovački sporazumi između Otomanskog i Habsburškog carstva. Oni su označili kraj rata između dve imperije i stabilizovali region. Bili su i osnova novih političkih i ekonomskih odnosa obiju strana. Mnoge tačke sporazuma i danas su zapanjujuće relevantne. Pored podsjećanja na istorijska dešavanja izložba koju ćemo danas vidjeti, postavlja i pitanje koje su posljedice ovih sporazuma za Evropu. Da li su oni bili relevantni za evropsku integraciju ili oblasti kao što su saobraćaj, ekonomija, politički odnosi, naučna i kulturna razvoj. Izložba je bazirana na kustoskom projektu univerzitetskog profesora istorije Harolda Hepnera sa Karl Franzens univerziteta u Grazu pod nazivom The Impact of Požarevac, 300 Years of Continuity in Europe. Prikazano muzeju, Univerzal muzeju Johaneum u Grazu. Želim vam da uživate izložbi. Prijatno večer.
So, ladies and gentlemen, I'm afraid I'm not able to speak Serbian. I understand it a little bit, but I cannot fluently speak. So I prefer to speak in English, and I would tell you three answers to three questions. The first question is, what does it mean, Požarevac? The second question, why did we organize an exhibition about this subject? And the third question concerns why do we show this exhibition also here? It's quite simple to answer. On the one hand, you know all that Požarevac is a relatively small city northeast of Serbia, but it's not the message. But the message is that in the last year, 300 years anniversary of the well-known treaty work in Požarevac was given, and treaty works means that we had a peace treaty between Vienna and Constantinople, we have a peace treaty between Venice and Constantinople, and we have a trade and sea traffic treaty with Vienna and Constantinople. So it's a consortium of relevant measures in the international relations at the beginning of the 18th century, and it's not only antiquarian information, but had a lot of consequences, a lot of impact on Europe during the last 300 years, and this was the reason to pick up this subject and to prepare something in this direction. When we look at not only the treaty work and the circumstances around it, but also the impact, we can see that the impact concerning the policy, not only the policy between Austria, the former Austrian Empire and the Ottoman Empire, but afterwards between Central Europe and the Balkan states, as hereditary phenomena of the Ottoman Empire, we can see that the economic relations were changing in the course of the 18th and the 19th century based on the stipulation of the treaties. And in addition, the traffic, the communication, all that had their starting point till today, till the era of flying and traveling by car, etc., in the philosophy of Ožarevac, and also the cultural perception between the Christendom and the half-Muslim world in the Balkans have got a lot of influences and new directions after the treaties of Ožarevac. And therefore, you can see that not only some rests, some artifacts exist in the different libraries, the archives, museums, etc., but also the infrastructure and partly also the cultural reception in the literature, in the music, etc., live still today and have their continuity. And so it's remarkable that first only a fact, a date, has a so long echo, a so long impact the peace treaty work of Ožarevac. And we started with the idea and the preparation of an exhibition now 3 years ago in Graz, in combination with the regional museum there, and had this exhibition in a German version, and a lot of material artifacts in combination for several months with several additional programs, and it was, I think, a very successful action. And it was the first time that the catalogues of exhibitions in these regional museums were printed out and then sold out, and so they had to make a second edition. And during the war, during the year, we continued to think and to plan and found a solution that only a reduced version of this exhibition in Graz, this German exhibition, was adapted to the Serbian public, to the Romanian public, and to the Turkish public. And so at the beginning of April in this year, the round way for the Turkish version started in Istanbul, and in the middle of April started the Serbian version in Ožarevac itself, and the Romanian version started at the end of June. And so it's a possibility, a opportunity for also a larger public to look with more or less simple messages in this complex subject, and to get some orientation, not only for something of the past, but also with some relevance for perhaps not only the present, but also for the next future, when I wouldn't say perhaps, but probably or certainly also Serbia will be integrated in the European Union. Because it's necessary and to underline that the historical connections between, when we look at the Vojvodina and Austria from today, there are not only some connections as a bilateral sphere, but all these phenomena depend also on connections to the neighbor countries and to at least half Europe, because some consequences of this context can also be seen in the Netherlands or in France or in Russia, etc. So it depends on the level of observing, of analyzing the whole subject, but it's quite representative. And therefore, we decided to make this exhibition and to prepare a catalog and to bring the most of the passages also in these countries and so perhaps we'll try to do that also for Bulgaria, but it's perhaps a conception for the next years. And it's not so relevant if we have an anniversary in concrete, because 1 year it more or less is not so deciding. It's more or less relevant to the method for some historical produced and stable community. And so I invite you to look at the different tables with the different aspects. I will not comment it because it declares it itself. And I hope you have perhaps some additional questions and I can try to answer you. The opportunity to bring this exhibition from Austria to these three other countries, Serbia, Turkey and Romania, would not be made without the substantial help of the Austrian Catholic Forums in Belgrade, in Istanbul and also in Bucharest. And so I thank you and the Ministry for European and International Affairs or
Integration.
Integration, excuse me, yes, the name changed a little bit. But this is also a connection between university on the one hand and diplomatic and cultural world.